And if I'm wasting my time,
these dishes are everything.
Then nothing could be better.
They start clean, they get dirty, and then it's my sworn duty to my parents to make them clean again.
And waiting for an honest word forever.
As an only child, this duty belongs to me alone. But I don't complain. This filth needs a good scrub. And I'm way more than happy to take care of it. And this world, this town, is no different. Sure, it was built with the best intentions. But it wasn't long before it was spilling over with the stench of evildoers.
For recalling every rhyme. From the book, the page, the line, the word, the letter.
These people are very, very good at what they do. They see unity and smiles, and it makes their insides choke. Is it something they're born with? Some unstoppable urge for disrupting the common peace? Or did some tragedy occur long ago, which deformed their view of tranquility?
Well, the window's turning blue.
I don't have the luxury of easy answers, but neither do I care. Evil is out there whether we like it or not, and it cannot be tolerated. The sad fact is that most people simply lock their doors at night, turn their security systems on, set their heads on their pillows, and that's enough for them. They're okay with the notion that there is more evil in the world than good, so long as it doesn't bother them. But not me. Oh no, not me. I'm here to make a difference. It's about time people woke up and smelled the bad guys. Not like it's difficult. They're corrupting our streets, vandalizing our children's futures with narcotics, and polluting our city's public drinking water.
People just leave her alone. She never did nothing to hurt you. So just leave her alone.
I may only be a freshman. I may be young, I may have limited resources, but I've never been the kind of kid to take a beating without giving one back. Rolling over in fear at the first sign of evil's icy cold stare will not work. No citizen is beyond playing a part in this fight. Every little jab at these monsters has its effect. There is no such thing as small justice. Oftentimes, the malicious will hide in plain sight. What they don't realize is that I looked there too. Shop corners, rooftops, Starbucks, makes no difference. I peered deeply into the darkest nooks and the shadiest of crannies.
You try to tell her what to do.
The people of this town need me, whether they know it or not. Frequently I receive looks which give off a silent appreciation. I can only hope that they look back into my eyes and hear me say, "You're welcome." Bad people mean business. In fact, many of them are businessmen by trade, taking pieces of the pie that don't belong to them. And they've sure done their worst to make a mockery of our economy. I shine my light in the darkness, and the darkness flees. If there were more lights out there, perhaps mine wouldn't have to shine so brightly. But evil has a natural tendency to regenerate like the severed tail of a lizard. I'm no idealist. I've never been under the impression that evil can be vanquished entirely. It's much too persistent for that. but with all my strength and all my will, it can be knocked down to the ground. And though it will never stop struggling, neither shall I. Neither shall I. To properly vanquish evil, you must equip yourself with the highest quality tools you can muster. As a young man, limited by circumstance, this mustering has been my greatest obstacle. I will not lie and pretend the job of a guardian is not an exhausting one. I will also not be blind to the reality that evil can sometimes exist in those who appear most innocent. Wrongdoers can take many forms. But in most cases, the darkness will make no attempt to hide itself at all. Like I said, this filth needs a good scrub.